Synology Directory Server is a centralized management platform that transforms your Synology NAS into a domain controller, so you can manage all of your users, devices, groups, and domain policies all in one place. In this video, we'll show you how to build a Synology Directory environment on your computer. Before you start, make sure that you've installed Synology Directory Server from the Package Center. After the installation is complete, you can find Synology Directory Server in the main menu of DSM. When you launch Synology Directory Server, a wizard will appear to guide you through first-time setup. Click Create a Domain. Enter a domain name and password that you want to use for the domain administrator account. Confirm your settings and click Apply. The system will then create a domain and set your NAS as the domain controller. Once your domain is created, you can view, edit, or remove the domain or domain controller on the status page. To add specific users to the domain, go to Users and Computers and click Add User. Fill in the information and select management options as needed. Confirm your settings and click Apply. Just double-click on a user or right-click and select Properties if you want to edit user details. On the Profile tab, you can assign a roaming profile to a single user. Roaming profiles allow domain users to access the same set of files even when signing in on different computers. You can also use the Connect option to mount network drives for domain users. The next steps are to configure your network settings and then join your computer to the domain. In the Windows System tray, right-click on the network icon and select Open Network and Internet Settings. Under Advanced Network Settings, select Network and Sharing Center. Click Ethernet or Wi-Fi and then select Properties. Tick the Internet Protocol Version 4, TCP IPv4 checkbox. With it selected, click Properties. Next, select Use the following DNS server addresses and enter the IP address of your Synology NAS. The alternate DNS server field is optional. Click OK on both pages to confirm your settings, then exit the window. Next, click the Windows Start button and go to Settings. Go to System, About. On the right-hand side, click Rename this PC, Advanced, and then click Change. These steps may differ depending on your version of Windows. Select Domain and enter your domain name. In the pop-up window, enter the domain administrator's username and password and click OK to finish adding your device to the domain. Your computer will need to restart to apply the settings. Click Restart Now to restart immediately. Once the computer has restarted, go to Other User and sign in using your domain credentials. The NAS that created the domain will be automatically joined to it. Domain users only need their username and password to sign in to DSM, access files, and use DSM applications, meaning that there's no need to remember many different account credentials. You can also join other Synology NAS to the same domain. Go to Control Panel, Domain LDAP, and click Join. Enter the domain name and address. Enter the domain password. Click Next and OK to add the NAS to your domain. Click Edit to schedule automatic updates. Here, you can easily update domain users or groups by going to Domain User, Domain Group, and clicking Update Domain Data. To make sure you're getting the most out of your Synology NAS, subscribe to the Synology YouTube channel or click on another video to keep watching.